Bible theologian and teacher John Piper once said, "The invincible purpose of God for creation and for his people will not be complete until all things are made new, and the glory of the Lord fills them all." And that's exactly what we witness in Revelation chapter 21. In verse 5, John hears Jesus say two things. "And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write these words, for they are true and faithful." They're words of authority, straight from the throne of heaven, and words to be written down so we'll never forget. You see, Jesus wants us to have complete assurance that no matter how much evil, suffering, and futility we see in the world today, he will make all things new. Now you may ask, how? Well, first, he'll make a new and glorious creation. John sees a new heaven and a new earth, for the first had passed away. See, creation will undergo a complete renovation, and everything that is evil will be replaced with good. Next, Jesus makes things spiritually new. John uses the picture and symbolism of a bride being prepared for her husband, a bride that's pure and holy. The spiritual purity of this new church is beyond description, like a stone that is transparent or pure gold that's as clear as glass. He makes things physically new, wiping away all tears. See, there's no more death, sorrow, crying, or pain. These two have passed away. And he makes a new relationship. "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God." See, it's a beautiful scene, a wonderful promise, and a hope for the future, a certain expectation. As Jesus brings all things together, then he makes all things new.